right, everybody. So when you're getting ready to put on your first landing strip, obviously consult the manual that has all the details. But an alternative to the way that we tell you in the manual is to take your first outer landing strip and let it run right off the board instead of cutting it and ending it into your nose blocking. So to do that, you can use your strip to define a line that runs off the board. Use a Japanese saw or a nice fine tooth saw to make a cut. Clean it up a little bit with a chisel, and you can glue your strip on and just let it run straight off the board. It's a little bit easier than trying to get it to fit perfectly and follow the curve of the board. It gives you a little more wiggle room to let it run straight off. The next two strips to the inside can then butt right up against your nose blocking, and they're a little less crucial because they'll never be seen. Okay, so you can see what the final product looks like. First rail strip runs off the board, gives us a little extra room to pull on it and get it into the right shape. The next strip on the inside just butts right into it. And when we clamp this down, we'll get this to be a better fit. Here's the final view of our rail strips and how they interact with your nose blocking. That first outer rail landing strip comes up, runs off the board, and the next one to the inside runs right in and lands on top of frame number one. There's no more room here for the next landing strip, so we just end it between the two frames here in the nose.